In this screencast, I'll show you how to find the energy transferred from a heated rod during a prescribed amount of time. So let's consider a rod. It has a diameter that's equal to 0.2 meters. It has a length of 2 meters. Its initial temperature is equal to 400 degrees C. The question is, how much energy is transferred? So what is the total energy transferred if the rod is placed in a bath of 25 degrees C that has a convective heat transfer coefficient of 400 watts per meter squared K? And we want to know what that Q is after 20 minutes. So the first thing that you need to do in a transient conduction problem, by the way, how do we know that it's transient? Because we're looking at how a temperature is changing with time. So the first thing we have to do is calculate this BO number, which is equal for a cylinder to the heat transfer coefficient times R divided by 2, and this whole thing divided by K. So the BO number will let us know what method of solution we need to use. So if we put in our numbers, we find that we have a BO number of 1. And in order to use the lump capacitant method, we need that our BO number is less than 0.1. So we're going to have to use the radial system with convection, which takes into account spatial effects in transient conduction. So our governing equation for a cylinder to find the total heat transfer is that Q divided by our normalized energy transfer is equal to 1 minus 2 times theta star 0 divided by our eigenvalue, and this is all multiplied by the Bessel function of the first kind of our eigenvalue. So that theta zero star is equal to C1 times the exponential of minus, now this eigenvalue 1 squared, times the Fourier number. And our Q0 is equal to rho times C times the volume Ti minus T infinity. And this is considered the maximum amount of energy that could be transferred. So in order to find our C1 and our eigenvalue, we're going to need a table that lists them as a function of the BO number. However, to use the table, we don't use the BO number that we use to check for lumped capacitance. What we calculate it as is just H times R, not R over 2, divided by K. So in terms of using the table, our BO number is 2. So let's take a look at the table and see what our C1 and our eigenvalue are. So here I copied part of a table. If we look it up with a BO number of 2, what we find is that our eigenvalue is equal to 1.5994, and our constant is equal to 1.3384. And take a look at the difference we would have gotten if we used the incorrect BO number. So now that we have those numbers, let's continue the process. If we go back, you'll see in order to calculate it, we need our theta zero star. We have our C1 and we have our eigenvalue, but we're going to need to calculate the Fourier number. So let's go ahead and do it. our Fourier number is equal to thermal diffusivity times the time divided by R squared. And remember that our time is 20 minutes, which is equal to 1200 seconds. So if we put in the values we have before, we end up with a Fourier number of 0.48. And just as an aside, you should remember that in order to use the one-term approximation, which we're doing here, your Fourier number has to be greater than 0.2. So now we put this into our theta star, and when you calculate that number, we get that theta zero star equaling 0.392. Now again, we go back to our original equation here, and if you notice, we have to find the Bessel function of 1.5994. So our Bessel function of 1.5994 is equal to 0.57. We're going to calculate our Q0, which remember is the maximum possible energy transfer. That volume's going to be equal to the volume of a cylinder. And so when we calculate this Q0, we end up with 9.72 times 10 to the 7th joules. And finally, Q is equal to that 9.72 times 10 to the 7th joules. And our final answer is equal to 7 times 10 to the 7th joules. So that's the total amount of energy that was transferred during those 20 minutes. So in a subsequent screencast, we'll look at a similar situation, but we'll look at a different geometry.